Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to part three of the Heavy Rain playthrough, and now we are
now we are Fat Guy, Private Eye, or as you people like to call him, Scott Shelby.
Wow, that was the fastest loading time I've ever seen in this game.
So Scott Shelby is a former cop, lieutenant actually, and now he's a private investigator who was hired by the families of the Origami Killer's victims to investigate the murders.
He also reappears in the DLC, The Chronicles.
Well, his...
Well, his voice actor, at least. But anyway...
The taxidermist.
Yeah.
Man at the desk gotta be able to help. Lauren Winter. Ring any bells?
No, can't say it does.
Seven victims.
Oh, you're... Seven victims right now?
It's eventually gonna be eight.
Oh,
Chips.
That Lauren Winter.
Yeah, look, he's got chips.
Third floor, last door on the left at the end of the corridor.
Thanks, man.
Been looking for weeks. Hope I hit pay dirt this time.
What's that mean, I hit pay dirt?
I don't know.
No duh, you take the stairs. What, do you see an elevator anywhere nearby in this danky place?
Who knows?
On the left of the end of the corridor, right?
I know. Last place door on the left at the end of the corridor.
Imagine if you knocked on someone's house, you're like, Lauren Winter? Who? You went the whore next door. Yeah, Lauren Winter is a whore and a victim.
Sorry, I only see clients by appointment.
She's not a whore, she's a prostitute. There's a difference.
Wait.
Huh.
It's $50. I don't kiss and I don't do any weird shit.
Well, what the hell do you do?
Fine by me.
I saw a video, it was like best Heavy Rain moments. That was one of them. I guess that's what they thought.
And you're gonna leave the money on the table?
Nope. I'm not gonna waste $50.
You got exactly 10 minutes when the alarm rings, it's over, okay?
I'm not wasting $50 if I'm not gonna get anything.
You should take your clothes off. We ain't gone all day.
Actually, I'm not a customer.
Ooh.
Oh, shit, a cop.
Ex-cop.
I should've known. What do you want, a freebie?
I didn't know cops got freebies.
It's a cop discount.
My name is Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. The families of the victims of the Origami Killer asked me to investigate the murders. I came here just to ask you some questions about Johnny.
That's Johnny. That's who we were talking about in one of the previous parts.
I already told the police all I know and have nothing to add. Leave me alone.
Man, this is bright on this camera. You want to be convinced?
The killer is walking around free as we speak. He'll kill again if he's not arrested.
Hey, Johnny's dead, so what difference does it make?
It makes a big difference, baby cake.
Compassion?
I understand, Lord. I know what you're going through.
Oh, yeah?
There's Johnny in the background.
Do you know what it feels like to find your own son's body on a wasteland? I'm sorry, I don't believe you have the slightest idea what I'm going through, Mr. Shelby.
Oh, you're the only one?
Did you just give me the finger?
Trick.
If we don't find the killer, there'll be other mothers who find their son's body on a deserted wasteland. But you're right. Why should you care? It's not your problem anymore, right?
You're acting like you're the only mother who's found their son's body on a deserted wasteland. There's John.
That's John. He was the kid in the beginning?
What kid in the beginning?
The white one?
Yeah. Huh. That was the kid that we were talking about.
Oh, okay.
Suspect?
Wait. Did you suspect anyone after he disappeared?
I meet a lot of pretty shady characters in my line of work. Sure, I thought of it at first. But it didn't seem to make any sense.
Why?
I don't believe any of my clients could have done that to my Johnny and all those other kids.
Disappearance?
Johnny.
Tell me about Johnny. What kind of kid was he?
Johnny was really a good boy. Sometimes he fought with other kids who called me a,
Yeah, whore.
In his own way, I think he understood what was going on.
Now, this is where I actually started to feel bad for her. At first, I didn't like her too much, but then I saw this and I was like,
oh. Want one?
No thanks, I quit.
That's brave.
Yeah, so I was hanging out with this dude.
Don't spoil anything.
I'm not.
We'll spoil things later on. Actually, we won't. We're not going to spoil anything.
No, I mean, this guy just looks like he wants to date rape her or something like that.
Tell me about Johnny's father.
There, let's do that.
A loser without a job who liked to beat me after a few drinks.
Son of a bitch.
He left the day Johnny disappeared. I ain't seen him since. Coward. Good thing he left.
Disappearance?
Johnny's
did Johnny live with him?
Why did you ask about disappearance?
I don't know.
Of course, I made sure he never met any of my clients. I wanted to stop, you know. But we needed the money. I was trying to earn enough to get us out of here.
The reflections in this game are very good.
Wait, I'm gonna say this. There was a character in the tech demo named Mary Smith, who was played by the same person as Lauren Winter.
Uh-huh.
I just noticed something. She says that
Mr. Shelby, I hope you got what you wanted. Now get out of here.
She says that she's doing this because she needs the money.
Uh-huh.
Her character in the tech demo, the person she played,
yeah,
she couldn't afford acting lessons because she didn't have money.
Huh.
No point in pushing it. She's not going to tell me anymore. Well, if you remember anything, the smallest detail, give me a call.
I thought he was going to leave the $50. I'm like, what's the point of leaving the $50 now?
I got to get out of here. I didn't learn squat. Well, worth a try.
Yeah, yeah. At least we can... today!
Now we can walk out.
And,
all normal, right? Everything is fine.
Yeah. I guess. Oh, by the way, he has asthma. Well, in this one scene, at least.
No, he uses an inhaler one more time.
No, but I'm just talking about... I don't really think it matters. This is the only time he actually needs it. I'm serious.
Shady-looking character walking by there.
I mean, sure, he buys the inhaler, but this is the only time he actually really needs it.
Laura, don't stop, baby. It's me.
Troy, what are you doing here? I already told you, I don't want to see you anymore.
Sorry, Del, but I really wanted to see ya.
Oh, no. You can actually leave without doing anything, but we're going to show it off.
Yeah, we want to beat this guy's ass for putting his hand on a woman.
What do you want, asshole?
Give me your wallet, Lauren, bitch.
Is everything all right?
She's just swell.
Who the hell says swell?
I don't know.
Get that door in and kick his ass.
Bitch.
You again? If you're looking for trouble, you found it. I'm gonna beat the shit up.
No, you won't, bitch.
Yeah, nice job beating shit out of him, dude.
You're really beating me up.
Yep.
Not bam.
I don't really know how I can give anybody a walkthrough on this fight. Just press the right buttons.
And be careful with the control stick, because sometimes you might move it to the right, but it might go, like, diagonally.
Uh-huh.
So that...
Ah, he's gonna rape me on the table!
I'll rape you just like I did with Lauren.
Yeah, they never really get too deep into the detail of why she don't want to see him no more.
But they mention it a little bit.
Yeah, he got too rough with her. But that's about it. They don't really explain what he did, if he, like, hurt her or anything, or gave her a scar or something.
No!
Are you gonna do anything else but say Troy no with your arms crossed? I mean, she's standing there nonchalantly, like, are you gonna help me at all?
I was gonna say, we already know for a fact that, I thought of this, could this have been Johnny's father, but it can't be, because I looked online and Johnny's father's name was Alan.
Huh. He's never named in-game, though.
I don't know why he was... I thought they said his name was Alan.
Who knows?
And it's not A-L-L-E-N, it's A-L-L-E-N.
But every time I play this, I never heard his name, but his name.
Maybe you'll hear eventually.
I'll see you again, asshole.
No, you won't. Seriously, that's the only time you ever see this guy in-game.
Are you alright?
Yeah, thanks for standing there while I got my ass kicked.
Better than him, I guess.
She's a woman, what's she gonna do?
Who is he?
Stand there and take her robe off, and then he'll just stop.
He was getting violent, and I told him I didn't want to see him anymore.
There, that's basically your explanation.
He'll probably be back. Sorry about the mess.
Mr. Shelby.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah. Don't mention it.
I think we can squeeze in one more part in.
Yeah, we can squeeze in the next scene. In this next scene after this.
Well, first, I'll see him limp away, like, ow.
Ow. Now in this next scene, we're going to be introduced to another new character. Agent, not Norman, Agent Namon Jaden. Namon Jaden, FBI.
With the scar on his face that we never learned where he got it.
There was going to be a DLC about it, but it was canceled.
Of course.
Looks like he's wearing lipstick.
I don't know. For some reason, I love the facial models of the characters in this game, but some characters look like they have on more makeup than they do.
Now, Norman Jaden, Naaman, he's an FBI profiler who was called in by the police to help investigate the Origami Killer case. I said Origami because a lot of other people say Origami.
Yeah, how do...
Some people say Origami, some say Origami, some say Origami. Some say Origami, some say Origami. Well, one says Origami.
Yeah, we never have to bring it up, though. But anyway.
Anyway, this is Norman Jaden's first chapter. It's called Crime Scene.
Yeah,
I literally know, like, all the chapter names, pretty much, so...
Well, don't give anything away, dude.
That doesn't give anything away. I'm saying this chapter's name.
I don't remember him driving up there. I thought he was already there.
No. Oh.
What's wrong with him?
We'll learn. Oh, they're letting these druggies in the FBI now?
Actually, it looks like that vial of potion that Rancid used to take in Power Rangers Time Force to keep him from mutating.
You know, I just remembered that. I remember he used to take that. So this is Naaman Jaden. You'll learn why we call him Naaman in a little bit.
He doesn't know if he's Boston or New Yorker.
Goddamn rain. Hasn't stopped pouring since I arrived.
I'm showing the thoughts because...
I'm really gonna love it.
I like the thoughts.
God, my hands are trembling. I gotta keep my act together. At least for now.
Come on.
Noted that name somewhere. What was it? Blake. Lieutenant Carter Blake. Yeah, that's it. Reporters. Already.
The zone is sectioned off, sir. Please step back.
Agent Naaman Jaden, FBI.
Agent Naaman Jaden.
You got a badge or something, Mr. Jake?
Yeah. Yeah, of course.
Alright.
Bitch, let me through.
Check. You can pass.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Blake. Is he
I'm
around?
I'm looking for Lieutenant Blake.
Is he around?
I saw him arrive earlier. He's here somewhere. Thanks.
That was used a lot in, like, online videos. His way of saying thanks. Thanks. I guess it sounds like...
Yeah, he was using a lot of stuff.
Thanks. Now we also learn about a cool gadget he's got. This is the 8th victim of the Origami Killer that we'll see about right here. Not the 7th.
Ooh, cool sunglasses. Why are they blue in his eye? Oh, looks like it's a device.
It's called Airy.
Video memo recording. Agent 47023, Naaman Jaden. Tuesday,
Naaman Jaden.
2011.
At least this is recent.
Yeah. The game came out in 2010, and... It was set in 2011.
You gonna hit R1?
It will let me. Oh.
Clues? Yeah, what the Airy does, you put on the glasses, you put on the glove, it helps you find, like, clues. Ah, that has nothing to do with this.
Unrelated to the investigation.
Let's look for your Lieutenant Carter Blake.
Lieutenant Carter Blake? Later on in the game, you'll learn that I hate Blake.
I can agree with you on that. Blake's an ass.
But you'll also learn that Naaman Jaden, I keep saying his name wrong, Naaman Jaden is one of my favorite characters.
So you're gonna walk around the puddle.
Blake?
Lieutenant Blake, I'm Agent Naaman Jaden from the FBI. I went by your office this morning.
Your office?
Now, if you're looking for rain, dead bodies, and highways, you come to the right place. Mike, can you tell that asshole with the bulldozer to stop for 5 minutes? I can't hear myself. Take care.
Right away, Lieutenant.
That might be important later.
Might.
Well, are you coming, Jake?
Yeah, of course.
So, what happened? Some guy taking his dog for a piss found a body about 6 o'clock this morning. We don't know much more right now. Based on what we've seen, looks like the work of the Origami Killer.
Origami.
Any witnesses? None yet. Given the neighborhood, I'd be surprised if anybody saw anything. Any news on the coroner? He's on his way, Lieutenant. We've been waiting for an hour, for fuck's sake.
Damn.
There are a lot of people on the crime scene. Aren't you afraid your men might destroy some clues? You don't find proof sitting behind a desk. We're not in the habit of trampling things into the ground if we're not in the FBI.
No. No, of course not. That's not what I meant.
single shit-stirring journalist within a mile of here. You got it?
This guy's got a real foul mouth.
He's...
Identity?
Has the body been identified? No, not yet. We should know more later today.
Anything else?
Do you have any leads? My men are going over to see him with a fine-tooth comb. If the killer left anything behind, we'll find it. Listen, I'm a little busy here. Why don't we discuss all this a little later, back at the office?
Well, no problem. I understand. Do you mind if I have a look around?
Be my guest. Hey, Jade, you come and see me if you find anything, okay? We're on the same team now.
I actually thought he was going to be an alright guy.
At first I thought, okay, cool. He's like a badass, but he's going to be cool.
But then he becomes a real dick.
Later on we'll learn that he's a real stupid guy. And
why don't we go investigate the body?
I'm seeing all the stuff.
Harry Cummings, sample of no interest. Comes from one of the policemen present on the wasteland.
Alan Pope.
Yeah, sounds like someone pissed. Nothing popped up. Yeah, just keep mashing that R1 button. You'll find something eventually.
Oh.
We'll see that in a little bit. Let's look at this body real quick.
What is this?
Looks like,
Harry Comet. The victim is lying on his back. No visible signs of violence.
Oh, a couple things to investigate.
Well, investigate.
Superficial wound on the right thigh. Blood analysis suggests it could be post-mortem. Probably a scratch that occurred when the body was being moved. The blood report indicates an advanced and long-lasting state of exhaustion.
Origami figure in the hand.
You're about to say origami.
Small origami figure in the right hand.
Origami.
Fingers were probably closed after the time of death.
Anything else?
Wait,
you looked at that.
The victim is Jeremy Bowles. Declared missing 5 days ago.
We'll see. Wait.
How is he missing 5 days ago? Does his mother, not care?
An orchid was placed on the victim's chest.
The origami. We'll learn about the killer's MO later on.
But anyway, up. Now, we saw some kind of thing in the air. Let's go look at that.
In the air, what? Oh.
Yeah, that looked like some kind of... Yeah, that. What's that?
It leads to stuff.
To plot?
I don't know.
Harry Cummings. Orchid pollen detected.
Ooh.
Probably from the flower left on the body.
Let's follow it. Ow. After that pollen...
Particles disappear in the tall grass. It's probably the end of the trail.
Let's look at this.
Let's see what this
Harry Cummings. Traces of blood on the railroad track. Analysis confirms it comes from the victim.
Come on, move it, Cracker.
Yo, Cracker. We'll learn that later. Ooh, footprints.
Footprints! Shh!
Footprints continue just after the pollen trail.
Blue's Clues reference.
There's a good chance that they're the killers.
Pretty big. Must be a real big guy. Ooh, something over there.
Harry Cummings. Traces of blood on the fence behind the railroad line. It comes from the victim. The killer came this way with the body and probably grazed it on his way through the fence.
True.
Are we gonna climb?
He came through the fence. Whoa!
Ah, damn it.
Quick time event popped up.
Yeah, that happens all the time. You're not gonna take Aerie off just in case he gets injured or something?
Right now I can, but... Screw it, I ain't calling Aerie off. Whoa. Okay, he still fell.
Whoa. Yeah. Even if you press the buttons correctly, he is gonna trip over his own 2 feet when you go up here. hallway? Hey. Oh.
Look at that. You got splashed and now look what he does.
Fuck you!
It's soaking wet.
That area right there, that looks like it's gonna be important.
Very common. Tire tracks on the side of the road behind the railroad line. Maybe the killer's car. And we have seen all there is to see.
Let's take Aerie off. Before we go blind looking at a computer screen.
I think I see enough. Better get back to the station before I catch pneumonia. There's a railroad track near where the body was left.
We just went from there.
Got that. Okay. Got it.
Why don't we just fall?
I ain't falling. I don't want Naaman to get dirty.
But that's all that happens. He just gets dirty. It's not like he gets killed or anything. I think it's time we brought that up. This game has no game over screen. Nope.
The characters can die, but if they die, then...
Screw it. You're going on without them. Right?
Yeah.
So, yeah. Try not to kill anybody on your way through here, because you'll feel like a complete douche if you let Sean die.
Heading back to the office. You staying?
Leave.
No, I've seen enough. I'm leaving too.
Thought them about anything?
You can't. There are no thoughts either. I'll beat you to the thing.
That doesn't mean you're gonna go under it first. He's still gonna go under it first. It's scripted. See what I tell you? Ring-a-ding-ding. Dude, what are you doing?
It won't let me go under.
Why don't you just stand there and wait? Don't be Baby Vinny. Don't be unable to stand in one place for more than 2 seconds.
They don't know who that is.
Our cousin, dude. We talked about him in the Spyro playthrough. Anthony, get your foot out of your brother's mouth!
Wait, no. How many people watched the Spyro playthrough?
Yeah, whatever.
5?
But out of all those 5, who are watching this? Whatever, who cares? Anyway, we're out of here.
Bye.
What?
Bye.
Ugh. Don't say that.
Hi.
How?
No. And, no.
Alright, anyway, next chapter's Ethan's, right?
Yeah. Can I pause?
Yeah, we'll break here.